It was 5 or so in the morning in downtown Chicago on that Saturday in late September, and basically, the whole city was still asleep except for Grant Park. We arrived on site and began filming immediately because there was this unique energy that was just indescribable, and it had to be captured. This was my first experience working with the Chicagoland affiliate of the Susan G. Komen Race for the Cure. It all started when Nancy G. Brinker promised her dying sister, Susan G. Komen, that she would do everything in her power to end breast cancer forever. And that is why over 10,000 people, including 600 breast cancer survivors, were on their way to downtown Chicago to show their support and determination to end breast cancer forever. As the sun came up over Lake Michigan, you could tell this was going to be a beautiful day for the 5K run walk and 1 mile fun walk. The sponsors and volunteers that gave so much of their time were finally rewarded with an incredible turnout as people lined the park waiting to give their donations and start preparing for the race. We spoke to a few sponsors to find out why they chose Susan G. Komen for the Cure as their philanthropy of choice.
Well, our philanthropy is breast cancer awareness and education. We do a lot of partnership with the Susan G. Komen Foundation.
Caribou Coffee has a coffee that's called Amy's Blend. It's actually named after our original roastmaster, Amy Erickson, who passed away to breast cancer.
Well, I've been involved for about 7 years, same kind of presentation, Church and Dwight products, donate $50,000 a year to Komen Chicago for the race.
We went right to the top of craft and they said to us, absolutely. This is about a race that has to have a finish line. We have to get there. We have to find this cure.
This event for me personally was a wake-up call. At the age of 9, I lost my mother to breast cancer because at the time, they were not able to catch it early enough before it spread, and the means and the technology was so different back then. I have some very fond memories of her, but the stories that were told to me on this day from family members, friends, survivors, and even the people that had no connection to breast cancer other than they just wanted to make a difference was so moving. I want to share a few of their stories with you.
Well, Ellen is my very dear friend who passed away last September from breast cancer. Her battle began 5 years prior to right after the birth of her third child. Her message was always clear, women get your mammograms and just fight for all you can because women shouldn't have to do this. And she didn't want her daughter to go through anything that she had been through throughout those years. So we're here to support her. You know, her wishes, what she always wanted, and we just wanted to be part of this great group.
We're the Burton family, and we're here for Mimi! Woo!
8 years ago today, I was diagnosed with breast cancer when I was 33. And 2 years prior to my diagnosis, my dad had breast cancer. And a few months after I was diagnosed, my dad's cancer had recurred and it had metastasized all over. So he and I were taking treatment at chemo at the same time. What a way to bond. And as I was finishing up my treatments, my dad was dying. So he died 6 years ago.
Oh, this must be an absolutely very special day for you. And you know what? I'll tell you, there's an energy about you. And look, you finished the race, and I think I saw you coming around the corner there.
I never take for granted that I can do this. I physically can do this.
Race for the Cure!
Thank you.
The Race for the Cure is so much more than a fundraising event. It's a gathering of caring people, fighters, 10,000 plus soldiers running, walking, donating their time to eradicate a disease that has devastated so many. We need to be grateful for the gifts that have been given to us, our children, our families, our loved ones, and also be grateful for the ones who have gone before us. This event is about the survivors. I met so many incredible people that have persevered and would not give up the fight, and that is truly the reason why I will volunteer my time to this event every year from now on.
So tell us a little bit about your race today. You told me that it's like your 100th race?
171st Race for the Cure, nationally, internationally. That's every Komen race that there is. And what an exhilarating experience it has been to be here at Grant Field in Chicago and to participate with the survivors and their supporters in the eradication of breast cancer.
Am I correct by saying that you're a survivor as well?
I am a conqueror. I was a breast cancer survivor until about 10, 15 years ago, and then I realized that I was a conqueror. I had gone beyond just surviving. And so now here I am, always with this optimistic and defiant outlook and being totally immersed in the enthusiasm of the event.
The Race for the Cure is held every year at the end of September to kick off Breast Cancer Awareness Month, and you can make a difference by becoming a sponsor, signing up a team, or gathering your friends and family together to help us end breast cancer forever. The Susan G. Komen for the Cure Chicagoland affiliate takes donations all year long, and you can find them on the web at komenchicago.com.